Welcome children, take out your geography book, chapter 5, natural and man-made disasters. Today's topic is earthquake. Earthquakes are caused due to the movement of the tectonic plates. Now why earthquakes are caused? Earthquakes are caused due to the movement of tectonic plates. The earth crust is made up of several continental and oceanic plates that fit like a jigsaw puzzle. Now, earth crust, what is it made up of? It is made up of different types of continental and oceanic plates, and it fits together and it looks like a jigsaw puzzle. The sliding of these plates under each other causes tremors and other. Now, when this plate slides under each other's pressure, they causes tremors and quakes. Volcanic eruptions and massive constructions of dams are in relatively weak zones can also cause earthquake. Now, volcanic eruptions and even massive constructions in dams relatively in weak zones, what it causes? It even causes earthquakes. Impact. Earthquake cause damage to weak constructions such as roads, buildings and bridges. Now, earthquake, what it cause? It even cause damage to weak construction, that is roads, buildings, bridges, water pipelines. It may also crack. The collapse of the building leads to loss of life. Even people get buried under debris. Now, when the buildings get collapse, it leads to loss of life, and people they get buried under the debris. Sometimes ground splits open due to impact. Even sometimes the ground plates get open. This often causes disruption of roads and railway transfer. And when ground splits open, it causes disruptions of road and even the railway transport system. Risk reduction measures. Number one, earthquake prone areas are to be delineated on maps. Now, earthquake prone area, it should be always shown on the map. For construction of buildings, lightweight materials like wood must be used. Now, in earthquake prone areas, for constructing buildings, lightweight materials such as wood must be used. Earthquake resistant design must be used for building. Now, in earthquake prone area, earthquake resistant designs must be used for the building. Geologically, weaker areas must be avoided for construction. Geologically, it is said that weaker area, it must be avoided for construction. All buildings in earthquake prone areas must follow guidelines issued by the BIS, that is Bureau of Indian Standards. Now, all buildings in earthquake prone area, they must follow the guidelines which are issued by the BIS. BIS, that full form is Bureau of Indian Standards. Now, disaster caused due to human activity. What are the disaster which caused due to human activity? Disaster may be caused due to human induced hazard. Now, disaster, why they are caused? Because of human induced hazard. Resulting in enormous economic loss of life and damages to the environment. Now, what it results to? It results to enormous economic life, that is loss of life and even damage to environment. Sometimes a disaster causes impairment that spans through generation, as is evident in the Hiroshima Nagasaki area of Japan even today. Now, sometimes what happened? Disaster. It caused two impairment and spans through the generation, and it is very important in Hiroshima and Nagasaki area of Japan even today. Disaster management in India. In order to build a safer and disaster resilient India, the Disaster Management Act 2005 established the NDMA. Now, to build a safer and even a disaster resilient India, the Disaster Management Act, which was passed in 2005, established the NDMA. Full form of NDMA is National Disaster Management Authority. The NDMA has the Prime Minister as its chair. Now, the Prime Minister, NDMA, it consists of a Prime Minister as its chairman, a Cabinet Minister as the Vice Chairman, and 8 ministers of state handling various responsibilities of planning, policy making, preparedness, mitigation, funds, reconstruction, and awareness building. Now, NDMA is a very big organization. It consists of a Prime Minister as its chairman, then a Cabinet Minister as Vice Chairman, and even 8 of the ministers of state handling various responsibilities of planning policy. They make different types of policies, that is preparedness, mitigation, funds, reconstruction and awareness of the building. The strategy guidelines of NDMA for disaster management. Now, what are the strategy for the disaster management of NDMA? That is, first is community-based disaster. First is the community-based disaster. Second, capacity development of in disaster-prone area. Now, this one, that is capacity development which is seen in disaster-prone area. Third, cooperation with national bodies, that is NGOs, and with international organizations such as UNDP. Now, cooperation with national bodies, that is NGOs, and even the international organization, that is UNDP, and even UNEP. Community-based disaster management aims at lowering the risks of a disaster and increasing the capacities of people to be more resilient. Now, community-based disaster management, what does it entail? It aims to lower the risk of the disaster and increases the capacity of the people to be more resilient. The community is the first responder in case of death. Now, community, which is what? It is the first responder in case of disaster. Community preparedness is important as it increases the capacity of the people to respond to a disaster effectively. Now, community preparedness, why is it important? It is important because it increases the capacity of the people and even to respond the disaster effectively. The community is also aware of the safe zones within the towns, villages where people can be rehabilitated. Now, community, even the community is very much aware of the safe zones, that is, which are within the towns or villages where people can rehabilitate, where people can be rehabilitated. The community members include people in police stations, primary health centers, schools, and local. Now, community members includes police people who are in police stations, primary health centers, schools, and local people. Planning and execution beforehand can reduce. Now, planning and execution in hand, they can be reduced. They can reduce the risk. Capacity building in public community would include. Now, capacity building and community, what does it include? It includes training authorities and local. First is the training authorities and local communities. Second, develop an early warning system. And third is practice excavation drills. Organize search and rescue operation. Organize health and first aid services. Organize relief coordination team. Build water and sanitation. These are the capacity building in the community. It includes all these things. Disaster management cooperation includes different phases of it. Now, disaster management cooperation, what does they include? They do different types of phases of action, the steps. Now, what are the steps? Response and relief. In response and relief, what happens? Immediate measures taken to reduce the number of casualties after disaster. What happened? The immediate measure, the first measures which are taken to reduce the number of casualties. Second is rehabilitation and reconstruction. This includes those operations that are taken up to bring back the normal condition of the living in the affected. Now, this includes rehabilitation and reconstruction method. What does it include? The operation which are taken up to bring back the normal condition, to means when a disaster occur, or the operation which are taken up to bring back the normal condition of the living beings in the affected area. Then comes the mitigation. It includes actions that are taken up to minimize the impact of it. Now, what does mitigation include? It includes the action which are taken to reduce the impact of disaster. They can be either structural mitigation measures or non-structural mitigation. Now, there are two types of impact, that is, these two types of action, that is, one is structural mitigation method and the other is non-structural mitigation method. Now, structural mitigation methods, what does it include? It includes building cyclone shelters in coastal areas, earthquake resistance buildings in earthquake prone area or building embankments for flood proofing a village. Now what does it entail? So first is to build cyclone centers in coastal areas, because coastal areas always cyclones come, so cyclone cyclone shelters buildings are needed to build cyclone. Then earthquake resistance building in earthquake prone area, where frequent earthquake comes, that is the earthquake prone area, and there it is very necessary to build up earthquake resistance building or building embankments in a flood. Now the villages where frequent floods comes, so there it is very necessary to build embankments. Now comes the preparedness. Then comes non-structural mitigation. Now what is non-structural mitigation? Include awareness building, mapping disaster prone areas, mock drill by disaster management teams. Now non-structural mitigation method, it includes awareness to make aware of the building, mapping the disaster prone areas, mock drill by disaster management team. Next comes the preparedness. This should be done in advance by the local resident, and it should be done previously before the by the local resident. NGO state that country to co-op with disaster better. Now NGO, according to the NGO, the country, it is very necessary for the country to cope up with the disaster better. Disaster can be avoided if adequate preparedness is conducted, planned and strengthened. Now it is said that disaster can be avoided if adequate, correct preparedness is conducted, planned and strengthened. Role of the government, the responsibility to organize rescue, relief and rehabilitation lies with the state government. Now responsibility, what is the responsibility? It is to organize rescue, relief and even rehabilitation. It lies to the state government. The central government supplements the efforts of the state government by providing financial and logistics support in case of major disaster. Now central government, what is supply? It supplies the effort of the state government and provides financial and logistic support in case of major disaster. Logistic support includes providing aircraft, boats, central paramilitary forces, national disaster relief force, medical relief and infrastructural relief. Now what does the central supplements the efforts of the state government? It provides financial and logistic support in case of major disaster. And logistic support, it includes to provide aircraft, boats, central paramilitary forces, national disaster relief force, medical relief and infrastructure facility. Nodal agencies responsible for disaster, that is flood. Ministry of Flood is controlled, Ministry of Water Resources. Cyclones controlled by the Indian Meteorological Department. Chemical disaster controlled by, looks after by the Ministry of Environment and Forest. Rail accident looks after by the Ministry of Railways. Air accident looks after by the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Mining accident looked after by the Department of Mines. Industrial disaster looked after by the Ministry of Labor. Fires, natural disaster response force and civil defense under the Ministry of Home Affairs. Now fires, these are looked after by the National Disaster Response Force and Civil Defense, which comes under the Ministry of Home Affairs. Now take out your diary, write chapter 5, that is natural and man-made disaster. Explain homework, revise the chapter again. And with this, I'm ending my today's class. Goodbye.